Good morning, everyone. How are you doing today? We've got this fellow. We got this one today. We got this one today. TGM, 15 tons. I just need to do the side straps. The other check seems to be fine. So all I need to do now is just to tie those straps. And then we'll go out. I haven't drove for a very long time such a short vehicle like this, like 15 tons. I know, it's looking like a joke, isn't it? I hope it's a good joke, not a bad joke. I don't know exactly what year is this vehicle. I have to look for the registry plate. But it's looking quite new model, but standard one. So this is what I have to carry today. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pallets, I think, all together. Everything is strapped by the side straps. Those straps are here. They ain't go anywhere. Yeah. This ain't going anywhere. We've got this, this door on here. Make sure it's closed. Ain't going anywhere. And also we got tail lift on it, so everything is plugged here and here. Okay, so probably I'll just leave it like that. Yeah. Vehicle from the front, everything looks okay. I've got the M6 stall as well, which is great. It's so small, it's looking like a 7.5 tonner. Yeah, here is okay as well. So I got my my number here, my name, but I got this here, so it might be a little bit confusing, but let's go up. So we got MAN today, which is not bad. I'm gonna put this here. So shift gearbox, so we got 4 and 4 central reverse. Okay, I think we'll have fun today with this. Okay, I haven't drove a shift gearbox for a long time. See you, brother. Take care, brother. My brother from another mother. Today I think it's gonna be fun. Honestly, I haven't drove a lorry since 23rd of December. Okay. The lorry looks... Wow, it's been a long time since I haven't drove this type of shift gearbox. You just need to make sure you got this knowledge in your mind. So you got 4 gears. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you press the clutch. Then is a button, you lift it up. Then you're gonna have 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah? it's not a big deal. So literally to go with 20 miles an hour, you need to change 5-6 gears. Sometimes you have to double clutch it, like clutch and then change the gear. Sometimes it depends how the lorry feels with you. If you're friendly with the lorry is gonna be friend with you as well. The reason that I'm holding the window down is just because I want to get the fresh air, because I will have a very long run. Well, very long, because I haven't drove for a long time. When you have to drive this type of vehicle, make sure you've got enough clearance between you and the vehicle in the front. I just drove 2 hours. Everything was fine until now. The road conditions were terrible, honestly. Very dark outside and then foggy as well, makes the journey to be delayed somehow. Honestly, I'm feeling so much better than what I was felt during this long drive. And now, because I'm feeling a lot better, I can drive a lot better and I can pay even more attention to the road condition and all that. It's quite useful thing that they got these gears here, so now we know we're in a 6th gear. Now we change into 7th, and you're gonna see here 7, you see? And then 8 as well, if it's the case. Okay, let's go with 8th gear and then we're gonna change back. Now we're gonna take second exit, so I'm gonna put into 4th gear, yeah? 4th gear, slow with the clutch. Here we're gonna full stop. Then again, 3rd gear. 3rd gear. Sometimes 2nd gear, depends what is the weight on the load. So we got 4th gear. We lift the thingy up. I should have put left indicator, but driving this manual sometimes doesn't give you plenty of time. And then we got 6th gear, 7th gear, and then when we got enough like 1300 duration, we got 8th gear as well. So now if we maintain between 1100 duration and 2100 rotation per minute, then it will be the optimum of this lorry anyway. And just to remind, so we got single carriageway 40 miles an hour, dual carriageway 50 miles an hour. If it's an A road, if it's an A road with two lanes or more than two lanes, 60 miles an hour, and then motorway 70 miles an hour. But somehow, including this speed limit, we must admit that sometimes, even if it's a motorway, sometimes we can have 50 miles an hour speed limit. We can have 40 miles an hour speed limit. So we must include this. But at the minute, it's an A road, it's a dual carriageway. It's, let's just say, 50 miles an hour, no more than 50, in my opinion. But some drivers, they go here with 60 miles an hour. Well, now it's up to you, because outside is foggy and you need to keep the distance between you and the vehicle in the front somehow, yeah? So just bear that in your mind, so you'll know exactly what you'll be able to do. On here I will just slow down, just leave this lorry to pass. 7th gear, 6th gear, 5th gear, yeah, so 5th gear, we just leave it like that, 5th gear, yeah, I'm not pressing the brake pedal, yeah, it will just slow automatically anyway. Now I just need to press the brake pedal, put the gear into the 4th, 3rd, right indicator, 5th gear, 6th gear, we need to take 4th exit, yeah? So, 1st exit, on here is a very, very dangerous. So double check in your mirrors. Don't worry about if you go too slow. Yeah, here you need to double check. No, nobody's coming. We can continue our journey. So we got fifth gear, yeah? Then sixth. So we need to take B4116, which is here, yeah? Left indicator. Anyway, we're in the lane, but just to make sure everybody is aware of our presence, because it's a big vehicle compared to the area that we're supposed to drive the vehicle in. We got the county of Warwickshire, or Warwickshire, I don't know exactly how to pronounce, but this is less important. The most important thing is, doesn't matter what accent I talk and whatever I say, I just want you to fully understand what I'm telling you about, yeah? So we got a very nice area, it's called Atherstone or something like this, yeah? So somehow we're just going where we just been earlier, but in this direction somehow. And just the office told me before I left the yard, be careful on the first delivery, because they want the stuff on the back of the shop. So probably it will take me a while until I will be able to find this shop in order to do the delivery safely, and then not to be far away from the delivery, because I don't have the pump truck, I think. I only got the Subaru. So today is gonna be some manual handling involved. Maybe second and third customer, not too sure. I think they'll have the forklift. So now gonna put into third gear. No problem. Third gear, mirror indicator, yeah. Slow, slow, slow. Indicator again, because we're going back to the lane. Fourth gear. Lift the gear stick up, yeah, the shift changer up. Now we're approaching our destination. So we're looking for Masters. We're looking for a bakery anyway. So I think this is the main road. So give way except for loading. So I'm allowed to go straight. So we go third gear. Yeah. Now we're gonna put the hazard lights, because we're going very slow, and just to let the others that we're looking for something around here. This is COVID testing center. Welcome to Atherstone. Let's see where is this place, because so we need 89 numbers. Any numbers? No numbers. We're going slow to see a number. TNT 102. So it's gonna be on the left side, on the left side of the road, except for access. So I think this is one of the entrances, so I think supposed to be there. Let's see. So we got the job must be here somewhere. Independent, Greg's 93. So here somewhere, Mercia, Masters. So the job is here, keep clear. I just need to find a way where to deliver. I think he's deaf. I'm just trying to tell her where to go, but she doesn't want to hear. So I think I'm supposed to park the lorry here and then walk through that alleyway. But anyway, I see that the road is going, so probably I'll go around, and if I need to come back here, I'll come back here, because it's a one-way system anyway. So it's a pleasure to deliver in such a place. Anyway, today, even if the lorry looks smaller compared to any other lorries, it's not easy as you think. We've got this bin outside of the road, outside of the pavement. Look, I just touch with the curtain textile. Imagine how narrow it is. So just because of that, I'm gonna go around. Hopefully I'll be able to find like this, then left it. But where? Because here? That's the problem. When you've never been here and you don't know, it takes a while until you'll find where you have to drop off the load, you know? So that's, in my opinion, the hardest thing in these delivery jobs. Not necessarily manual handling and not necessarily things like that, but most of the time it's just to find the place is the hardest thing. And I think this is supposed to be the road. Oh, this is bus station. Maybe here. Taxis and deliveries only. Station. I'm allowed to go there or no? I don't know, man. Vehicle try to pass on here. I don't know. Taxis only. Ah, he told me something about taxis only, actually. I remember something. So the arcade. So the job must be in the back of this here somewhere. So actually, maybe it's not really bad. So that's 65 Long Street. So I need this 89, and I think it's not this one, might be the next one. I'll just stop here to have a look on the Google Maps as well. Okay, folks, I'm just gonna go to have a look where is this thing. If it's not here, wow, the door is fucked up. If it's not here, I'll just have to find somewhere else, because at the minute I'm parking the loading bay, I'm allowed to stay here half an hour anyway. So time is now 8:15, so I'm allowed to stay 8:45 at least. It might not be here, it might be in the next one, but if I... Ah, so this is the gang actually. The gangway. So I think the delivery should go here somewhere. Nice drawing, man. So apartments 85. I think it's this door here. I just have to double check. So probably I just need to come with the sack barrow here. It's gonna be a very hard delivery. Okay. So the bakery is here. As you see, keep clear, nowhere to park around here. Okay. Hello. Good morning. I have a delivery for you. Here, where do I need to go? Because I don't know, it's the first time.
Oh, okay, one second.
I'm park on the back.
Yeah,
yeah, I'm park on the back.
Are you?
Yeah. So where I have?
Go through the alleyway.
Yeah.
And there's a taxi rank, isn't there? There's an office.
Yeah.
Just around that corner.
Around the corner.
Yeah. There's a white van.
Yeah.
We're there. I'll
yeah.
meet you up there.
Yeah. No problem. Thank you. I left my gloves in the van. I just need to bring my glove. So she told me in the back, so actually I'm in the right place, because I'm in the loading bag anyway. So probably half an hour should be enough to do a pallet. But never underestimate a pallet, because them pallets are quite heavy. So she told me something about a van. So I think supposed to be this one. Let's see what we have here. There, yeah? No problem. One second. So where do you want the stuff?
I'll tell you. Just a minute. I'll give it to you.
Yeah? If you can keep the paperwork and I'll take a sign.
Here.
Here, yeah?
Here.
No problem. I don't know if I will be able to use this one, but I'll take with the sack barrow. No problem. Okay. Let's see what we have here. So that's the lorry, by the way.
So
I'm parking the loading bay, goods vehicles loading only at any time. Half an hour only, yeah? From all I've seen, didn't see any pump truck. Probably it might be in the front of it, maybe. If not, that means I'll just have to take it with the sack barrow and that's it. Let's see. We'll try. If it's not any, not any. Even a pump truck here, if I can have a pump truck from here somewhere, from a shop, it will still be good. I didn't see any pump truck, honestly. So okay. Oh, so is that pallet on the right? Actually, it's not very bad. So I can put them on them and then it's still okay. Because anyway, I will make sure this is stays here. There's no pump truck anyway. So now this is LCO VC Masters. Every time check for the label. Because sometimes it's a different pallet anyway. From here, I'll try to do it like that. So this is the sack barrel, you see. By the looks of it, it's shit, but I'm just gonna do the job like that. So another thing, I need a cutter and I don't have. So I just have to use my bare hands somehow. So even with them gloves, it's still not good. I know, mate, I know. I know it's not a very decent job to do manual handling. This is the job that they have at the minute. So there's nothing else to be done. Yeah. Let's try to bring this down. Bring it down, put on this, then bring in the shop, job done. So 1, 2, 3, 6. It's not really, really bad. It's this type of tail lift, okay. Just need to be careful with those two white boxes. And the sack barrow is not in a good shape either. So I'm trying to do my best. Come on. As long as the products are in the shop, that should be okay. On it, mate.
No,
okay. Yeah, on the loading bay.
Huh?
On the loading bay.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes. granulated sugar. So need to be careful with this, because the bag might broke anytime. 25 kilo each bag, so it's not very light delivery, let's just say. But compared to that pallet, it's still good. Four, so that means 100 kilo. And with this one, that should do. Let's go down. Ain't gonna go anywhere anyway. Ah, lovely jubbly. I've got the loading bay clear. I'm happy. Okay. You see? That's why I put the sack barrel. To be a lot easier to take it out, you see? Yeah. Because I don't have another handle, I will struggle. But so I insisted to have this sack barrel, because otherwise I would have needed to take bag by bag. Imagine. Not good, isn't it? So this sack barrel is really bad as well. Really hard to maneuver it. But it's better than nothing, so come on. Come on. Honestly, I don't know what is that box. It might be a freezer or something. But the office didn't tell me nothing about the box, so I have to call them to ask them if it's anything inside. One of the bags is fucked. I think it's this one. No. Here will be much easier with the pump truck, take the pallet, put there, and that's it. Job done. You know, I'm not manager. Okay. Let's finish this. Boy, oh, come on. Just the sack bar. No, it's just broken. The sack bar is broken. Yeah, it's the only thing I can work with, unfortunately. So all done for you.
Don't you have 5 bags of sugar? 1, 2, 3, 4. Granulated sugar, 5 here.
1, 2, 3.
Yeah, no,
4, 5, 6, 7.
5 plus 7. Oh, okay, you put it. Oh, one here, 8. Should be 8.
It might be this one. I don't know what is inside.
That's cornflakes.
I'll double check for you, but this is what is in the fish.
Have a look here.
Yeah, no problem.
5 granulated sugar.
Yeah.
2 icing sugar.
Yeah.
And 1 caster sugar.
Right. It might be
so
this
5,
one.
5, 7. So it should be no.
No, it's not there.
That is this cornflakes.
Yeah. What about this box?
The sultana. The 1 bag.
Oh, yeah. I'll double check for you, but there's nothing else on the pallet. No, there are 4 there.
1, 2, 3. Yeah, 1 sugar less.
Yeah. I'll double check for you. Yeah. I'll come back in a second.
1 sugar.
Yeah. Ah no, it's a back here, fuck. My bad, I didn't see it. Ah, Robert. My bad. This is the same color like that cardboard. I couldn't see it. Robert. I told you I'm blind. Now you believe me. Just found the missing item. Everything is fine. Yeah?
What you want, the yellow in your white?
White for me, I think.
Okay.
No? Honestly, I think it's the same thing, but yeah.
Tomorrow.
As long as you're happy, I'm happy.
We're happy now.
No problem. Everything. Thank you so much.
Okay.
It's all good, yeah?
Yeah.
No problem. Thank you so much. See you. Okay, job done. That's the second one. That and that. Third one. 14 feet. Okay. To this here. Sometimes we do mistakes. Because that's why we're humans, yeah. The lift up. Right, so we finish with this. Now trying to get out of here. And I've got that bin off the side. I've got this van as well. I've got taxi as well. So, lovely Jeffrey. Getting steamed up, so just third job is somewhere around 22 miles, so it's gonna be quite a long drive, actually 21 miles. Well, I've done a mistake with that sugar because honestly I didn't pay attention what is left. That color of the bag was nearly the same color with the cardboard underneath, on top of the pallet, sorry. Yeah. So I've done a mistake, but I didn't leave the place without deliver. So delivery has been done in less than half an hour anyway. I find the place, customer is happy, I'm happy, company probably is happy, I don't know. So just carry on. So that's why they send this vehicle out, because it's quite smaller compared to the 26 tonner MAN. If you see that beast in this tight area, will be, well, I don't think it's impossible, but it would have been a lot harder, you know. Fresh air. Even with this lockdown, somehow it's okay somehow, because there are not so many people on the street. So that means I can do my job without stress, you know. Six. Now seventh, and then just after that, eighth gear. We got the plate here showing is gonna be a roundabout further down. At the roundabout, we need to take second exit. So seventh gear, sixth gear, fifth gear, and here we press the brake as well, little bit, just to slow down. Now we got fourth gear. We use the shift changer. Shift changer again, fifth gear. Go around the roundabout. Left indicator. Sixth gear. Mirror. Mirror. Continue the journey. Then seventh gear. And just after that, eighth gear. Both hand on wheels, and that's it. So you see, I wanna say, if you see me sometimes staying like that, don't do like me. If you can, please stay with two hands on the steering wheel. I've got experience and I've got knowledge, and I can avoid many dangerous situations even at the last second. So don't try to be me, because you'll never be me, as I will never be you. Everyone is different. Yeah, everyone, they got their own style, everyone, they got their own capacity. All I want to say if you keep both hands on the steering wheel, you got more chances to control the vehicle safely. Yeah, with one hand sometimes is like this, if you take a hole, like, you'll end up there in the nowhere. So all I want to say, just take care a little bit of yourself, and everything should be okay. Look at this Speedy Gonzales, 40 miles an hour, but he goes with 50 at least. Yeah. So it will be too early to take the other brake, but probably after second job or after third job, we'll see how far away is one from another. Because we just finished in the postcode now, CV9. We're going to DE14, which is Derbyshire. Yeah, and after that we go in Derby, probably in Central Derby, not too sure. I have to double check the paperwork. Because I used to go to Derby, but the only places I've been there to do traveling, and that was for Enterprise, when I used to go to the Derby office, and that was all. But I'm not very familiar with Derbyshire, and doing multi-drop around Derbyshire and around this part of England. For me, it's a pleasure to be here. And also, I got some people from this area, Derbyshire. I think it's called Hello Mr. Alan. Alan, and along with your wife, that you're both watching my vlogs, I want to thank you so much. And I want to give you a shout out in this video. Because you always send me Facebook page message. You always tell me you like the vlogs, and now the time has come to say hello. And I'm feeling great when I got subscribers and people that they watching my videos from all over England. For me, it's a pleasure. honestly, I'm feeling great, and even if I will have 100,000 subscribers or million of subscribers, or I don't know if it will be possible somehow, even if I will have that number, I will never forget people that always support me and always being kind to me and things like that. So I will never forget people that they deserve my respect. Yeah. At the minute we're on A5, it's quite a famous road in England, A5, probably most of the people they know this road, before the motorway were built and things like that, this road been there for ages, and here I am, just with my companion, man, 15 tonner lorry, a joke. So now again, press the brake, put into fifth gear first, fourth gear now, fourth gear should be okay, but somehow if you go uphill, use the third gear. So now fifth gear, sixth gear, and now I think should be okay, because anyway, look what we have in front, we have fog, so I just turned the fog lights on and see how the thing's going on. So we got such a nice road. Someone did wave at me, but I seen it the last time, so if you watch this vlog, I wave back at you. Yeah, it was with a small car, I can't remember the car, can't remember anything, but someone waved at me, so I wave back. What I want to say is, we're in National Forest, this is how it's called, the National Forest over Seal. So if you see me around here, give me a shout, because really, most of the time, I'm blind, you know? Lovely place, mate. A444. So now we got 30 miles an hour, and I need to slow it down. Slow it really down. Yeah. Automatic vehicle is so much easier to control. So, handbrake, mirrors, second gear, third gear, fourth gear, lift up, fifth gear, sixth gear, and that's it for a while. We got a vehicle that's turning right in front, so we don't want to work ourselves too hard, yeah? Enough clearance, yeah. We've got Ben Lorry trying to get back on the road. So, fifth gear. Sixth gear. Somehow I'm enjoying all this manual gearbox, because it just reminds me when I used to drive some other vehicles that I probably will not have a chance to drive them again. So 30 miles an hour is enough into this area. Should be plenty of speed. 30 miles an hour is too much, especially when it's foggy, when you don't have visibility. It says 40 miles an hour speed limit around here, but 30 is plenty. Sixth gear, fifth gear, because this lorry might turn left or right at any given time. I used to be a bin man, a bin lorry driver, and I know how it's like, especially if you don't know where you're going, and then you've got a driver's mate that tells you exactly in the last time. And believe me, it's not an easy job. People will think it's an easy job. It's not an easy job to be a bin lorry driver. It's one of the hardest and toughest jobs to have. If you don't believe, just go straight for it, mate. Last two remaining. Wow. fifth gear, shift gear down, fourth. Fourth is plenty here. Slowly, slowly, don't accelerate, now we accelerate. Indicator. Fifth, sixth. Seventh. Single carriageway, yeah. National speed limit apply. So that means I have to slow down. Yeah, I have to slow down to 40, yeah. I told you this vehicle it will be a lot harder to maneuver. If you're not feeling comfortable to drive shift gear split box, don't take it out, mate. It's not for everyone. Because you might do a mistake and you might fuck the gearbox. Second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. You see, sometimes doesn't go, so sometimes you need to press twice the clutch. Yeah, it depends on the angle as well, it depends on duration as well. Yeah, it depends how further down you press the clutch. Sometimes it's going, sometimes doesn't. That's why you need to be prepared to press two times. So we got 8 gear here, we need to go down. So 7th, 6th, 5th, but not very hard because the pistons might. So be careful when you lift the clutch. Now it was a test anyway, but I didn't press the clutch and release it on the full extent. I just wanted to see how much can go. So handbrake, one hand on the handbrake, one hand on the steering wheel. You've got in the gear. Now all you need to do is just to go. We got that stubborn one as well. Third gear, fourth gear, fifth gear, sixth gear, seventh, eighth. So 8 gears just to go at 37 miles an hour. Just for you to remember how much easier would have been to have automatic gearbox. Like just press the accelerator and that's it. So 7 gear, 6 gear, so we don't press the brake pedal. Yeah? So now look, I'm not pressing the brake pedal. I'm not pressing the accelerator. The vehicle is just keep going. Yeah? Because it's downhill, uphill. So you need to have some knowledge about physics, about geometry, yeah. You need to be a driver is not so easy as you think. You need to have some knowledge about. Look, we got someone in the front, hazard lights, because the road is blocked in front. So we put hazard lights. We let the others know. Now, second gear. We don't have visibility. This bin lorry driver stops here. Why in the world do you need to stop here? So that's another thing when you got a bin lorry driver in front of you, because you'll never know where he's going. So that's why better to keep a safe distance in order for you to appreciate the distance even at a better scale. So we got 6th gear, 7th, that's it, plenty. We come back into 6th, come back 5th with little bit of brake. Yeah, because if you put 5th and it's more than 34 miles an hour, the pistons are gonna go through the bonnet. Yeah, so now 6th, 60 is plenty. Some little bit of brake, fifth. So that's why I'm telling you some of my tips, just to drive safe. No matter how many times you press the clutch, no matter how many times you press the brake, no many times how press the accelerator, just make sure you're in full control of the vehicle. Because if you're not in the full control of the vehicle, bad things might happen to you, to the people around you, and to the load you carry, and especially to the vehicle that you love to drive. So need to be a little bit safe. Yeah, this is the reality. This is the information that I've learned and that I achieved, and also the information that I want to pass to you free of charge, as you see. Yeah, because I didn't charge you anything. Yeah, I just offer you the information that you need in order for those roads to become safer, to become better, lorry drivers to become more experienced, and then all of us will be more respected. No matter of manual handling, lifting, things like that, doesn't matter. If you do a job, people tend to judge, you know. People, they think if they got a class one job, they have to take the piss with others. No, you don't have to take the piss with others, you have to respect everyone. Okay, if you don't want to do that job, that doesn't mean you have to laugh about someone that actually does that job, you know. Because remember, once upon a time, you were like that man, when you didn't have any choice, and then you done shit jobs. So just bear in your mind that sometimes, and most of the time, you need to think about it, yeah? 1.5 miles away. Not too far away. As soon as I'll get home, I'll try to edit this vlog, and I'll try to make it a little bit larger than before, because I've just done some questionnaires, let's just say. And just ask all of you, how would you like to see the vlogs? Because you know, you're my audience, so I need to ask you first. I've got a motorbike in my back, so just to make sure he's not going any of the side of the vehicle at the minute. Just if he wants to overtake, he's free to do so, but I will not recommend into this type of area, which is built up area, and the road gets tighter, especially if it's been an historic place or something like that, more than sure. So we got a roundabout, fifth gear, brake, shift gears down, fourth, stay in the middle lane, here, handbrake, second gear, clear both sides, third gear, fourth gear, indicator, look in the mirrors, watch for the motorbike in the back, because he can go. Just gonna drive a little bit slowly so he can overtake me, because I don't like to have him on my back. Pleasure is all mine. See? So I got sixth gear, and then seventh, and anyway, it's 30 miles an hour here, I think, not too sure. I've seen something with 30, new 30 miles an hour speed limit in force, yeah. So seventh should be okay. I'm just gonna leave this vlog a little bit longer, it might be boring, and that probably I will not cut this vlog like how I done with other vlogs. I will just leave it as it is, because honestly, takes so much time. I think I should be into this lane. It takes so much time to edit, so much chat, and average view duration is the same, like if I put a vlog long, and that is gonna be the same. So what's the point of spending all my time, all my day, all my night, if the people will skip the video all the time. So let's just say I've had like 2 hours video, 2.5 hours video. People used to watch 10 minutes, 15 minutes maximum, you know? So I've done it 1 hour and they watch the same. 10 minutes, 11 minutes, 12 minutes, you know? And I've done the vlog really compact and I've done it in such a manner that it will keep you there in the screen to watch, to laugh, to enjoy. And the people still skip the video because I can see. You cannot see, you're just a viewer, but I'm a content creator, so I've got access to many YouTube features, so I can see that. So it doesn't really matter, you know, because the view, the audience and the average view duration and all that is gonna be the same. So that's why probably I'm not gonna spend a lot of time editing the vlogs and that. I will just copy paste and I'll put to export the file and that will be. So I'm looking for TCO, the corner. First I'm gonna turn right here because it says it's unit 2. So let's see. So this is Russell Street, Russell Street Motors, LCO Trading, I found it. Okay, so we got third gear, fourth gear. Let's see how I am able to go inside there. By the looks of it, they're supposed to have a forklift. So I'll just reverse down there, okay. Anyway, the pallet is the one on the back, so if I reverse a little bit and I open the curtain, that should be great. Now even if the lorry is so small, I don't have so much visibility and the turning point is so much different. I don't know if I'll be able to put it from first time. I'll try. This guy is passing there. A little bit in front rather than touch something. Okay, I know it might sound like amateur, but better to do my job safely, yeah, because in the end I don't have visibility on the back, so anything can happen to anyone. Okay, let's go to see what they say. This door is fucked, honestly. Okay, let's go here to see. I don't think they got a forklift or anything.
Hi mate, you're right.
Hello mate, okay. I've got a delivery for you.
Lovely. We just took it as close as you can to the door.
Have you got a forklift or something?
I haven't, no.
Or a pump truck?
No.
No.
No. They've known this for about
7 years.
7 years.
So every time they do it on manual, like
no, they always come with a tail lift.
With the tail lift, but yeah. Don't have the pump truck.
The other day they come in a van, a transit van.
In the van?
Yeah, and I said, what do you want me to do? I'll have to put a... Have we got a pallet out of there?
Yeah, just an empty one, so I'll just take from there and put on... It would have been so much easier, like take it out.
Yeah, I know. They've known for years, mate. They've always come with a tail lift.
No problem.
Is it just broke, is it? Or
No. The tail lift is okay, but I don't have the pump truck. If you can
have... I might have a pump truck, but it's a bit rusty.
Doesn't matter, as long as it's doing the job. Yes, it's okay.
It'll save us both some time.
Yeah. Can I help you or?
It's just awkward to maneuver, so it might be easier just lifting it.
It might be okay actually.
Yeah.
Better than killing myself, you know.
Yeah, like, exactly, yeah.
Yeah. John, sir. Yeah. I've asked them in the morning and they don't have anything, so.
No, they're rubbish, aren't they?
Well, I don't know. Because I'm agency, so today I'm there, tomorrow I might be somewhere else.
Right.
Yeah.
Might be easy just lifting it out.
Yeah, should be okay.
You sure?
To take this turn should be fine.
We'll lift it if you want. It's a bit awkward, you see.
Thank you.
A bit old and knackered like me.
Yeah. No, it doesn't matter this. As long as he's doing the job, it's okay.
Lovely, mate.
Thank you.
Oh, we're not going to get through there, are we?
We will, yeah. Everything is possible.
Look at that, mate.
Yes. Inch, yeah.
Awesome, mate.
Thank you. Wow. So much different than killing myself. I don't understand why they don't put the pump track anyway. Because they should have put pump track in the vehicle. I told them in the morning, they said they don't have. Madness. It's just the way it is. So I'll put next to that. That should be so much easier. Put it all the way down and then happy days. First time I see something like this. Because imagine if I needed to take box by box, bag by bag. Oh. So awkward to work with this mask. As long as it's staying like that little bit, I can take the pallet out, should be okay. Oh, let's see. Let's see if I'm able to move it. So this like that, okay. So actually it's working, I can't believe. Let's see if it's, because on this pallet it might be a ton actually. It's very heavy. So normally I should have opened the curtain and then to take the pallet. But I thought that is much easier if I do it like that. Hop. So no. It's a very, very hard to maneuver it. It's very heavy as well. No space as well. Hop. Come on. Gonna put the whole of it. Because it's not all plugged in. As long as you stay there, take this off. So actually it's like this. Okay. Very hard to work with this type of stuff all the time. The fucking, because the warehouse don't care. They just put the pallets in our van and do it. You know, it's not always handy. with me, it's fuck heavy. Fucking hell. Heavy and the floor is slipping in every direction. It will be done somehow anyway. Hop. Slowly, slowly. Job. It might be too much on the side. Ah no, it's okay. Look at this. So imagine if I had to take bag by bag, even the tail lift says that it's too much. It's fine. Honestly, it's so heavy.
Oh.
There's like a ton of it.
I think I was given this, and I thought, yeah, you know what, I might need one one day.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. I've used it twice in seven years, this.
It's always good to have one.
Yeah,
you know?
It is. Just chuck it anywhere, mate, honestly.
I'll put it back where it was, no problem. Just as long as you're happy.
Yeah, just put it in backwards, it's fine.
I think at the front there.
Thank you, mate. I'll sign your paper.
Yeah, cheers. No problem. Thank you so much. Wish you all the best.
Thank you.
Bye bye. See you. Okay. So now to put the pallet. Okay. Customer is happy. I'm happy. I broke this pair as well. These two, and then happy days. Happy days. Yeah, let's go. come on. Okay, job done. Take the key. Back on business. Okay, let's go out of here. So I just need to turn left here, it seems. Left and right. Thank you. Wow, honestly, if this guy was not there and he didn't have any pump track or anything, he's safe for access. Okay. Was not any pump track or anything, literally been impossible to do this job safely. Would have killed my back. Would have need to use the tail lift and the sack barrow and all that. You've seen what sack barrow I have. It's shit, man. You put 3 sacks of sugar and it just barely can move that. Imagine. You've seen all that pallet full of sugar. Imagine how many trips I would have do, because probably 7 trips at least. Maybe. Why Rob? Why Rob, you are in the middle of the road? Rob, tell me, why you're in the middle of the road? Tell me, Rob. Well, the answer is to get enough clearance and not hit anyone. Boom. Now we're on turbo mode. So actually it's a nice town here. This left, but the sat-nav is in holiday for some reason. Wow, I took so large. Come on. My mistake. I forgot that I was in fifth gear. Now, fifth. Sixth. The sat-nav sees me somewhere on a planet. I don't know on what planet it sees me, but now seems that the sat-nav is okay. So imagine, I am not used to this lorry even now. If I had to drive this vehicle every day, that would have been so much easier, so much better somehow. So here, left turn. So it seems like it's been a tribunal or something, like justice is, this is what is wrote on it. So it seems like that building been really, really important. The height of the bridge should be okay. My vehicle is quite small compared to these big fellows anyway. Yeah, so we got 21 miles. Until the next job. Somehow it's not a bad distance, it's not very close as well. As now we're going towards Derby, because at the minute we're on Burton on Trent, I think. Not too sure, have to double check the paperwork, because I'm not usually coming into this area. So we put fourth gear. Just have to wait now, because I didn't know exactly what this guy is supposed to do. On brake, but I'm still with the feet on the clutch, because I got second gear. I think that driver is lost. Hello mate, heads up, might be better day sometimes. It's quite confusing for me sometimes because I'm thinking to something else and I forgot which gear. All the time I need to look here to see what gear I've got. I'm here in the middle of nowhere. There are some industrial estates here, but other than that, it's not so much going on, especially in this time of the year. I've got camera for the back, but I'm not using because it's not torquing or the camera is dirty or something, I don't know. I'll try to fix it later on because now I'm too busy to drive. So fifth gear, third gear, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh. We got 40 miles an hour speed limit, so we can use seventh and actually little bit of eighth gear as well, so it's not bad. It's so much better now when I got visibility, when I know where I'm going, because it's a lot better when you got light, when you got visibility, you know the signs, you've seen the signs, you know the road markings, you know where you're supposed to be. Not like in the morning, honestly. I don't really like that portion of the road on M6 going south to Birmingham. So between Manchester and Birmingham, M6 south. When you got that Staffordshire, next to Stafford Services around there, when they do that road works, I don't really like that area because I've just seen, and I think it's like a race course there. It's like everyone is trying to prove in front of another that is faster, better, or things like that. It's stupid, man. In my opinion, a better driver will be one that will drive slowly and then will keep enough clearance from him to the vehicles in the front of him, you know? So that will be an excellent driver. But a driver that puts the life in danger of everyone, and imagine, you got 40 tons, whatever, you got class 1, you got class 2, class 1 is not big difference, you know, because if you got a class 2 which is 32 ton full of sand or full of cement or something, it's gonna have nearly the same impact, you know, maybe a greater impact, because the class 1 is made from tractor unit and the trailer, which is two different parts, and class 2 is made from a solid block. So it might have a bigger impact if it's a class 2 actually, like bang. So imagine if you lose control of that vehicle and you bang the other people, what is going to happen, mate? You know what I mean? Like, you need to be careful. Need to be careful. I don't know what I've done with the tail lift key. I think I didn't take it from there. But we'll have a look sooner or later. Because anyway, there's nothing I can do at the minute. I think I put it there somewhere. Just have a look and I'll have a chance. So now we're back on A38. M1 North, 23 miles from M1 North, not bad, not far away from Derby as well. So we got national speed limit applies, and we got A road, which dual carriageway is 50 miles an hour at least, and we got in the same time A road, And I think from here should extend to 60 miles an hour actually. But I'm going with 50 because it's better to stay okay rather than receive any ticket or things like that. Yeah, this is what I've learned in the school. Single carriageway 40 miles an hour, dual carriageway 50 miles an hour, motorway 70 miles an hour, but the lorry is limited to 56 anyway. So, you know, sometimes class 1 lorries they got 60 miles an hour, but we need to keep our speeds controlled, because if we don't control our speeds, then the speed will control us. Oh yes, we're somewhere in the middle of nowhere. So guess what? We just heading towards this job, obviously. Well, 2.8 miles away. But look, not the dirt that I've got in the window, because I cannot remove it. Look what is in the back of this window. Look, man, it's so amazing. Come on, you must love this, mate. Love it. Today, the run, it's amazing. Today, it's something that you cannot describe in words. You must need to be here. And then you'll understand what I will try to tell you. Oh, not far away. GoPro, stop recording. Yeah, I think he's in this industrial estate actually. Let's see. Yeah, the job must be here somewhere. So we're looking for artisan. Artisan. Stanton Road. It's so bright, I can't see anything. Veterinary design whirlwind. I'll just park up here and put on Google Maps. It seems like it's somewhere on the left side, further down. See, if we will be able to find it. John Greenlord. John. Ashbourne Community. Alton Cars Reception Homes Carpet. The job must be here somewhere. Haley's. Must be one of these. Breakfast. Might be here. Let's have a look. Runway Cafe. Tanning Peak. DJ Paul Hollage. Google Maps show me here somewhere, but can't find it. Must be the next left. Don't know if I put anyone on the back. I'll just turn around here. Very dirty from this salt spreading and whatever is on the floor, and I'm running out of liquid as well. This sun is fantastic. Dead engineering. Here somewhere must be the place. Royal Mail. Artisan. Okay. Let's see. Where they got deliveries. Maybe around the back. Park. I think he's here. Just need to go out and they said something about 11 o'clock, so actually I just need to take a break, and anyway I will need to reverse after that. So if I put the vehicle anyway, I just need to wait for them, because I remember now, they told something about 11 o'clock. Right guys, so I just waited a little bit, like 20 minutes, because the booking was for 11 o'clock, so actually I came earlier than expected. So that means I've done a great job. All I need to do is just to reverse in that yard. But I need for this one to go. Just need for this one to overpass, overtake, whatever you call it. Come on, mate. Thank you. Okay, if he wants it like that, let's do the job. All the time, make sure you select other workers, some tacos. They don't care about, so other work, yeah? So, tight it from the back. So, this pallet, and on the other side you got another one. Yeah. My pants, but I need to take this as well because this is about safety and things like that, so doesn't matter. Nice one. Well, I don't think there's anything here. There's nothing there. Just to double check. Okay, and on the other side. Um, On this pallet, there are two customers. It's one for you, one for another one. So I just need to take off, I think four of them, yeah. So yeah, only this one. Yeah, I think it's a little bit of ice there, so that's why. Yeah, pretty solid. Not sure exactly. One, two, I think those four boxes. Can you double check if you don't mind? Just two.
Yeah, it looks like.
Yeah.
That's four boxes.
Okay. Yeah. One. That's the last customer. Yeah. Will that be alright if I stay another 5 minutes to do the tightening? Yeah, yeah, cheers man. So now, all I need to do is just to take that pallet, put it there, put this on the pallet, and that's it. That's east, you know, the one that you use to make pizza. I can do pizza from the scratch with this. And this actually should stay in the fridge, not like that. But if this is how they want it, this is how we deliver it. Moving anywhere, it's too solid. So all I need to do is just to close the curtains. Oh. Come on. Yeah. tight from both sides. Close this. Okay. Happy with it, happy. All done. Thank you so much, mate. Have a good day. It says unchecked, but it's actually checked. So now I need to do this. Side as well. Don't think it's working properly anyway. Think something is wrong with it. Close, close. Okay. Didn't see it. Okay. Just park it outside there and sort my things out. Vehicle here to sort my things out. Okay, so we got first, second, third, fourth, lift up, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, but now it doesn't allow me. Okay, so we do like this. First we go out here, mirrors here obviously. We got another driver which is lost. Another one here. It's quite busy industrial estate here, and you know why it's so busy? Because all them businesses, they got the base just in front of the street. That's why. So every time the shunters going left, right, straight, back. So it's pretty difficult to work in such a environment, you know. So now, happily and luckily, we're going out of this of this estate. We done the job, three pallets, boom, 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 job done. We got next customer full pallet, then last customer, four boxes of yeast, and then drive back to the yard, and that's it. So actually, it's not too bad today. I thought that would have been a lot harder, yeah, and could have been a lot harder if didn't have that pump truck. Imagine, had to take that manual again. And I think this next customer is manual as well. So I don't really know what to say. But anyway, that pallet, then that four boxes, then home, and that's it, job done. Time is now 11:30. From 5 o'clock until now is not bad. If you look on the timing as well, and in this time that I mentioned, include the break as well, because I've took my break as well. Because anyway, I had to wait for this for this booking. So guess what? I've done everything. All I need to take care about those two deliveries and drive back, and that's it. Yeah. So we got fog again. Even if it's light outside, we're just gonna turn on the fog lights just to make sure we're using the equipment that we've got. In my opinion, the company is okay, honestly. If you go inside of the warehouse, everything is clean and nice and put it nicely. It's one of the cleanest warehouse that I've ever been. But when it comes to the lorries and the back of the lorries and the pallets and pump trucks and that, it's not really nice like how it's in the warehouse. But as an overall, I think it's a good job and can be a lot better if I would have a pump truck with me. Take the pallet, leave the pallet, go. That's it. It would have been so much easier. Okay, not far away. So all I want to say is, we just come up here and then we're gonna go back on ourselves. You know, this is how the run is scheduled. Nothing I can do, mate. I would have do the other one first, then this one, then on the way back to Manchester. Now we come up here, then go down to Derby, then up here again, you know? Like, oop. Didn't put the indicator, didn't have chance. But anyway, I think it was obvious that I was turning left, no? Pretty nice now. The weather is very good at the minute, 2 degrees, but a lot better than what we did have in the morning. So the job has to be here somewhere. The name is Beach William and Son, Lee Brooks Road. Well, the road is not this one. The fault of that guy, because he should have waited for me first and then. But obviously, because he's a class one driver and he's taking long time and all that, I just let him, you know. Here shows me a roundabout. Is no more a roundabout. He shows me there a roundabout. Actually, this shows me where I was earlier. Road ahead close. Access only.
I need access. Shut up.
Let's see if I will have enough access. If not, probably I just have to come back again here. Road ahead close. But that one went straight on. Just showing me the job is here somewhere. So 48. So must be on the left side. Let's see whereabouts. I think is this Howard's here. Yeah. I think is this one here. It might be this one here because it doesn't have any number or anything. Looks like a bakery anyway. But I need to find somewhere else to park because here is not really indicated, not really recommended. Or park here. I think it's this one here. Looks like an abandoned place anyway. It says something about Howard anyway, no? Howard? No, Beach William and Son. Okay, let's go find this place. Because I don't know where it is. It might be this building. Or see. Yeah, beach, bread, cups, cake, savory. Yeah. Hello mate, hi. I've got a delivery for you.
Yes, yes.
Bitches. Yeah,
take
here.
It down there.
You got a forklift or something?
A what?
A forklift.
No, no.
No? You got any pump truck by chance?
No.
Because I need to take box by box then. So yeah, I'll just hand you the paperwork then. So where do you want the stuff?
Right. Well.
Yeah, because I haven't got the pump truck with me. That's why. They didn't give me, so I just need to take with the sack, borrow, like, this is how it is.
Okay, right. Are you in or?
Only if you got someone that has a pump truck, would it be much easier. Yeah. Yeah.
Right. Can you dump it there?
All the stuff here, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
No problem.
Yeah, I can help it, sir.
Okay.
You can.
I don't know if I can put on them trolleys. How much can you put in them? What's the weight? Yeah. It's like a pallet of stuff.
No, no. If you put.
Yeah.
You could put like 5 bags on there.
Yeah.
Or
yeah.
No I'll bring
problem.
A few.
No problem. Thank you. Cheers. Okay. Where is the key? Wow, I need that key. I don't know where it is. I need to find the key. Fucking key. So is 2019 Reg, 15 ton, 8.5 meters. So it's 3 meters shorter than Mercedes Actros anyway. So I'll try to put all the stuff into them. Okay, of course. We'll do this job, no worries. Wow, it's, even with them on the wheels, it's so much better than carry it on that sack barrel. It'll take me loads of time. So it's that pallet on the right. It's not so many things, but excuse me. Don't stay. Don't worry. If you can give me that, yeah, just. Thank you. They put so much for it. Yeah. I have to use the key. I don't have choice.
Now we're done then for the day.
Yeah. 5 o'clock in the morning. I've been up.
So you're ready.
Yeah. But I have to drive to Manchester, so it's quite a long drive from here.
Yes. Put all those brown ones on there.
Yeah. Okay. This one. Thank you very much. Okay. Yeah, go on. Take this out.
So they can be taken.
Yeah. No problem. Thank you. Thank you. Da 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 da. Thank you. Ah, the other two. Yeah. Thank you. Imagine if I would have taken on my own like that. That one is broken as well.
Yeah, but how come you haven't got a pump truck?
No pump truck. And in the morning I asked them even for a sack barrel. They gave me from another van that, because they don't have. So the last. Thank you.
Oh. Okay, do you want to take those two?
Yeah, no problem. Thank you. Come on. Won't move anywhere. Thank you very much. That's the last one? What about that box?
Oh, it's empty.
Yeah?
Okay.
No problem. If you're happy, I'm happy, so. If you want, I can bring this. I can bring this if you want to take them if you want. Thank you. Yeah, yeah. Thank you very much. Lovely jubbly. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Really appreciate it. Have a good day.
Okay.
See you. Okay. Okay. So, that's done. Anyway, I have to go up. So, close this one. One, two, three, four. Next customer, that's it. Very lucky today that I got so much help from the customers. So today, actually, the customers, today the customer saved my day. Just otherwise, I would have been, fucked up. Really, really fucked up. Hello, hello. How you doing? I'm on my way to the last job. In order to do that, I need to take the exit into here. And guess what? I just received a phone call from the agency, and it seems like they've been offering me a job tomorrow for a different company, a company that I never worked for. Probably I've been there to do the beans or something in somewhere in Bolton. I can't remember. But they offered me that job from a different branch, from a different agency. But yeah, it's okay. And they will pay me another £10 for fuel, which is not bad after all, because anyway, I need to have a job somehow. They just told me it's going to be something like driving, no handball involved, nothing. So just arrive to the place, open the curtain probably, or flatbed. I'm not sure what vehicle I'm supposed to drive tomorrow, but in any case, should be okay. Or maybe I will just go with some other people or on my own. I don't really know. But we'll soon find out. And I'll let you know as promised. At the minute, I told you, I just came back to Derby. I was in Sutton in Ashfield, and I just come back to Derby. There's no point. How you can schedule the delivery like that? Maybe because of the time slots. I don't know. It seems funny for me to go in a place and then come back in the same place somehow.
BMW. I might have been here before. I don't know. Anyway, 4 miles left. Okay, happy days. And this is what that guy told me on the phone. So, few jobs, blah blah blah. Happy days, anyway, happy days. he might know me actually, but we'll see. so good, and I have work, you know, because honestly, it's not necessarily I get bored indoors or things like that, but what it kills me is just this uncertainty. Like, I expected to have job until after Christmas, you know, like 2-3 days or something, but not even that I had. So I've just expected to work, I've just expected to do something, because in this driving, if you don't drive for more than 1 week, 2 weeks, you become like jelly. You lose all your knowledge, you lose all your reflexes and things like that. Because of course, it was like a holiday for me, actually. But a holiday which I was stressed and depressed, because I didn't know if I will have any job, I didn't know what's going on. That's why it drove me nuts. Here. Larger, because I've seen that there's no one there anyway. So now looks like A500, to be honest with you, very similar. Everywhere in UK you can see them yellow cameras. Average speed limit. You go over the speed, ticket. Boy, quite a big estate here with all the jobs here. Sainsbury, home base, all this. So now, Ring Road, Loughborough. A6. So this A6 goes from London, or maybe further down, goes to Scotland. Oh, long way. Long way, mate. Borowash. Spondon. So I guess it will be a right turn somewhere. Yeah, as estimated and expected, it's going to be a right turn. So now we change the lane to stay into the right one in order to take the fourth exit at the roundabout. Yes, and of course, reduce the speed, use the brake pedal as well. Fifth, sixth, here is not road markings anything, so I guess I'm okay. I need to take this exit, sixth. This BMW driver, amazing. So, nearly. I was 29. Fifth. second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, third, fourth. You should have waited from the first time, not job. It just tells me 8 miles. Did I done something wrong? Just park here, because I was paying attention to the traffic. So I actually couldn't find this company, but now I found it, because honestly I was looking around and it's this estate, but it's going something else, because on the paper is a name and then in the reality it's having a different name, and I forgot something as well. This okay, let's go. Bagiba. Okay. I don't think I need this actually. Let's see if I can climb here. No, I can't climb. Just need a lift a little bit further down in order to get inside of the vehicle. Okay, so it's called Project D actually. Unit 1. Where is the guy anyway? They don't have ladder, they don't have anything. I don't know where I have to go. Is the first one or? Let's see. Is here or where? This is supposed to be unit 1. Only them 4, mate. Everything. Yeah, no problem. Yeah, but yeah, next door. That one.
Outside the shop, sir.
Yeah,
yeah.
Because yeah, this is east, this is furniture, it's
no,
different.
This is a different one, mate.
Ah, yeah, no problem. Just.
I don't know if it was food, I'd
yeah.
Keep it.
Yeah. What the fuck is. Which door, mate?
here. I don't know which door. Here? No one here, no one here. There's no one here. On the other side. Yeah. I don't understand, man. Let's see. There's no one here, man. Here. No one here, man. Where to deliver? Which one? This one? Which one to open now? Now I'm look here. No. There's no one here, man. Project Donut, Project D. Mm-hmm. There's no one here, man. I just need the signature, that's all. You see, four boxes can take longer than two pallets, three pallets. That's a fuck yeah. There's no one there, mate.
I don't sign for them.
Yeah?
They don't sign
for them. Where do you want the boxes?
Yeah, here? Leave me with them, mate. I'll sign for it. Yeah,
no problem. So, if you can sign the white one and you keep the yellow.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Oops. I was looking for this place all over. Couldn't find it.
It's actually called Project D.
Project D. Yeah. Because they say Bagiba here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it's that as well, apparently.
Yeah, yeah.
But it's Project D, but that's one there.
Yeah, right? No problem, eh? So you got like 40 bags of East. Anyway, if it's here, it should be cold enough to keep them.
Yeah, leave
so
me,
you
mate.
Keep the yellow one.
I'll find them, yeah?
No
yeah,
problem.
No, I'll find them anyway. Yeah. I'll bring them to you.
On, I'll put it there, eh?
Yeah, no worries, mate.
Just. Delivered. I think the bin man is waiting for me to take them bins, maybe. Anyway, I have to go up. How to go up if I don't have how? No ladder, no nothing. Very hard to work like this. Football. Three points of contact. Not really. But the job is done. And now I just want to go home. Okay. So now all I have to do is just to put the suspension up. How dirty my gloves are, and in the morning they were brand new. Every time I have to take brand new gloves, brand new this, nobody gives me nothing for free, man. Okay, last job has been done. We're going back to Manchester Trafford Park. So we're getting out of here. Honestly, the job earlier with three pallets took a lot less than this job here. Why you don't put on the paper project this so I know to which company I'm going? You put Bujiba, Bagiba. Who is gonna find this fucking name? No one. Who is gonna find this place? Nobody. If you put that, no building like that. So that's why, this is one thing that I don't understand. I search on Google. I search on everything. Actually, the postcode was okay. Brings me somewhere around there. But the name of it, you just have to knock every door to ask. And some companies, they're closed. You don't have who to ask, you know? Every time I'm going to this Derby, every time, I don't know where to go, honestly. Because every time it's putting me through everything. So I'll just have to find somewhere to stop and put again the sat nav, because it drives me nuts, honestly. Because it's all this big district in the middle of everything. So just because of that, I just want to go on the motorway, because it's so much easier, you know? Just drive and that's it. Put on cruise control and that's it, you know? GoPro start recording. Okay, so I done my sat nav, and now I got this traffic light again. In every 100 yards is a traffic light. It's great, isn't it? Let's go out of this place. Third, fourth, fifth. Fucking car, man. Fucking car drivers, they don't give a fuck about anyone. They don't care. Okay. If you want to overtake, overtake. Just put me to city center Matlock. Ah, so I guess it will put me to A6 to Stockport and all that. But the good thing of it, look at them graffitis. Now you got the chance to see all them graffitis. Yeah. Look at the good parts, what can I say? Miles, 2 hours. So imagine, it's gonna be every time. That's why I choose this one. I wanted to take motorway, but in this case, we're gonna have a lot better landscape and we're gonna use them gears all the time.
first, second, third, fourth. So today we're doing driving school, no problem with that. So we got again a roundabout in front of us, police in the mission undercover. Actually not so undercover. Nice view, of course, but not this rubbish on the window, on the windscreen. Boy. Welcome to Derby. Screen watch. Let's learn together. So first, second gear, third gear, fourth gear, lift up, fifth gear, sixth gear, let's learn together how to use the shift gearbox. I need to change the lane because I will turn right. Wow, what an area! Whoa, amazing! So, I don't go on the motorway, I just go here on this A52, honestly. Even the sat-nav collapsed just because it's too nice outside, man. Amazing. So I'll just have a nice road towards the yards. Yeah, this is not busy around here, it's just single carriageway, which I really need to be careful at some point, because you got all them funny bends and things like that. So to be really careful. So now all is done is, all is doing is just engine brake. Wow, lovely area, mate. From 50 miles an hour, suddenly it's 30 miles an hour. Nice. Derbyshire, Warwickshire, all this share. Still 30 miles an hour. Few houses, not so overcrowded around here. So I guess those people, they have all their houses or lands from generation to generation and all that. Would you like to live here? I would love to, but I don't know if I can afford. And honestly, some people might consider that there's nothing to be done around here. Wow, I just spoke on the phone with one of my subscribers. So it seems like he's been ill as well as I've been a long time ago. You remember when I told you about that situation that I've had? So he had the same symptoms. And probably Corona, mate, Corona. Maybe. Corona extra, maybe. Someone smiled at me, which is good. So we got another one. We got loads of cameras. This is what I've noticed. into this area, loads of cameras, loads. I'm gonna plug back the cable, because otherwise I'm just gonna go like that forever. This is where I was, 12 miles, but now I'm somewhere else. Wow. So, would have you take the same decision like me, instead of going motorway to go through here? I really like, I prefer to drive on here if I know I will have sufficient clearance, not low bridges and things like that, and to be daylight as is now, because in about hour and something it's gonna be dark here. So guess what, we left the yard where when it was dark, we came back when it's dark. So actually we're living the night and the day, as well as tomorrow I got job 7 o'clock, so probably I'll wake up 5:30 something, because I need to travel to Wigan, Bolton, somewhere around there anyway. So it will take me a while, especially in the morning when everybody's rushing to go somewhere, but hopefully with this lockdown some people will stay in and will not be so much traffic like before. Will be so much better. Wink Hill, the hill that winks. Telephone box in the middle of nowhere. Interesting. Now we got 50. Now we're setting off. An amazing area, mate. Amazing, isn't it? Why in the world to go on the fucking motorway if someone... I've advanced a little bit. I'm on Macclesfield right now. We're trying to find a way out of this magnificent town, which actually is. So we need to follow this road, A523. It's 20 past 3, mate. Took loads of time. Loads of time, honestly. And even if I was on the motorway and things like that, I don't think I would have arrived earlier than what is scheduled on this route. Anyway. Macclesfield train station. It's been a fantastic day so far. Honestly, imagine, and you can do that on yourself sometimes, and you'll understand what I'm saying. When you drive so many vehicles, so many different vehicles, and then you got a break for 1 week, 2 weeks, then you'll not feel so good like before. So not necessarily confident, you'll not feel like you're having the same abilities, capacities, you know, sometimes it happens like this. What I'm surprised is to see them two tower blocks here next to the hills, you know, in the middle of all the houses and the places. Very surprised. I came into the Trafford Park and I forgot to go in to put fuel. So now I'll just go to the petrol station and I'll top up the level of fuel. I should have stayed on the other lane, but I can't turn that sharp. So now their price. More than sure. Just came down that road and I forgot to put fuel, so now I'm just going to put some fuel. Citroën Creative Technology, mostly road. Okay, let's go. Hopefully that the pump will be clear, because anyway it's getting dark now. I want to get home, honestly. I'm hungry and I would like to have a coffee as well. Let's see which side is the reservoir. Wow. The reservoir is on the right. Okay. That means I can go and top up the level of fuel from this side, which is great. Okay. Topping up the fuel, and now I'm gonna take this side because it's gonna be left at the lights, then left at the roundabout, and then in the yard, so I don't have to go around so many times. You know what I mean? Oh, 4:15, probably 4:30 I'll be finished. But anyway, just driving back to the yard. If you're down this road, just remember, always go with 30 miles an hour or less than 30 miles an hour, because you'll get ticket here if you don't pay attention, because here is called like mobile camera area around Trafford Park. So don't think if people goes with speed, don't think it's gonna be like that all the time, because you'll have a big surprise. One of my friends just been fined in this area, so you might take notice and advice just not to do the same, because you don't want 3 points on your license or 6 points, or you don't want too much trouble on yours, no? So I guess, oh, yard. Ah, so this guy finished before me. So actually I think it's someone else which didn't finish a part of me. Might be someone that has bigger rounds to do. So now I'm just going there, open the curtain. Come on baby, don't disappoint me. Go in the yard, open the curtain. Happy days. Thank you. gates are open. Oh, the gates are closing. No. I thought that the left gates would have closed. This guy is loading. So I guess if I put next to it, should be okay. Yes. You guys needed to load it for tomorrow. Tomorrow I am not booked for here. Maybe I should put further, because you might need this space to. I need to put further down. Because he might need some space to load this MAN. So if I put on here, I guess will be better. Yeah? Yeah? Yeah, he will have space to go on both sides. Okay, no problem. Supposed to be okay. Just gonna go outside, open the curtains, and happy days. Do my checks and everything. Okay. I don't have my gloves because I just threw them. I forgot that I will need to open the curtain, because on the petrol station I couldn't find the plastic gloves, you know. So now I just have to wash my hands again. As you know, when you top up the fuel, you don't want to put hands on someone else's hand, and you know. Things like that, hygiene and things like that. Okay. On the other side. Okay, just open it from the front to the back. Very dirty. Okay. Now to open the other side.
focus. Okay, job done. Let's go. Okay, I've just finished with the paperwork and things like that, and the guys are happy. This is the lorry that I was talking about. So this is MAN 26 tonner that I drove. I've got a vlog. Actually, I've got two vlogs. Yeah. And this is the lorry I drove today. So small compared to that. So, let's go out. Wow, this car is so fast compared to that. I drove manual all day and now I got manual again. So, once again, I want to thank you so much for watching this episode. Thank you so much, guys. I owe you so much. And hopefully that tomorrow I will video as well. And hopefully that will make another vlog tomorrow as well. Keep in touch. Take care. See you.